You would use enable, where you want a respondent to be able to skip a field, but could actually enter data in the field. The reverse is true for the disable command. You would want a respondent to skip a field and not be able to enter data in the field. I'm in the Form Designer with the E. coli project open. The form I'm using is the Food History No Check Code form. Here, I want to disable the Doctor Visit Date field such that if a patient did not visit a doctor, then a value can't be entered into that field. I also want to disable the hospital admission date if the patient was not hospitalized. I can click on the first field and see that it is a yes-no field. I can also check the data dictionary. To get to the data dictionary, I'll go to Tools and select Data Dictionary. The list appears. I know that these are fields 44 through 47, so I'll scroll down to those. And it shows that they are yes, no fields with date fields following. I'll close this. And now I'll navigate to the check code icon at the top of the page and click it. I'll start in the upper right and choose the field block for action. I know it's page 1, so I'll expand the page. And I'll scroll down to Doctor Visit. I'll expand that. And I want the action to occur after the respondent chooses the answer no, so I'll click After, and I'll click Add Block. And now you see the code on the left. Now I'll go to the Add Command box and click If. The dialog box opens, and here is where I will create an if-then statement. I'll choose the doctor visit variable, and it equals no. For the then statement, I'll click the commands icon and choose disable and doctor visit date and OK. Else, enable doctor visit date. I'm going to go back to the then portion of this statement and add the clear command. I'm doing this just in case a respondent may have jumped around and may have entered data in several different places. The clear command makes sure that data does not inadvertently get into the database. I'll select the doctor visit date and click OK. Now I'll click OK. And you see all the code on the left. Now I want to do the same thing for hospital visit. So I'll scroll down to hospitalized, expand that. The action will be after the respondent chooses no. So I'll add the block, I'll choose if again, in the dialog box, it will be hospitalized equals no, then we'll disable the hospital admission date, and OK, else enable hospital admission date. And again, if I want to make sure that no data is entered into that field, I'll click Clear, Hospital Admission Date, and OK. Now I want to validate my code to make sure that it works, so I'll click the Validate Check Code icon, and in the bottom in the Messages box it says today's date and that it is valid. I'll save my work and close the check code. In order to test the work that I've done, I need to go to the Enter Data module. I'm in Enter Data, and I'll scroll down to the fields. I'll check No for the patient requiring a doctor visit, and you'll see that I can't type anything in there. Was the patient hospitalized? No. And again, I can't type anything in there. You have just been shown how to use the Disable and Enable commands in check code in EpiInfo 7. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out all the user support videos.